Once again, this is Dr. Hatem Eleishi from Dr. Hatem Eleishi Medical Center in Cairo, Egypt. What doctors do to make sure that patients on DMARDs don't get infections? The most important side effect that you can get from a DMARD is that it can increase your susceptibility to an infection. Why? Because both the officer cell and the pro-inflammation molecule that we are inhibiting, because of their role in contributing to your autoimmune disease, this is your autoimmune disease, soldier cells attacking the joints and making them inflamed, are also at the same time playing a role in protecting your body against attacks of microbes, those microbes that try to enter the body. So when we inhibit them, we might be giving a chance to a microbe to attack our bodies. How do we solve or control this problem? How do we solve or control this problem? By doing the following things. The first one, we doctors, we take measures to prevent infections in patients who are prescribed DMARDs. This includes, but is not limited to, getting needed immunizations. At least annual influenza vaccine is given to patients who are on DMARDs. Instructions to wear masks when they go to crowded areas. Instructions to avoid contact with anyone who has a respiratory infection. Instructions for good oral hygiene, good control of blood sugar if they are diabetic. Paying very good attention to any small wounds until they heal. Number two, being very meticulous with the doses of medicine that we use. We prescribe doses of DMARDs that are high enough to induce a good response to control your disease, but that are not too high that they significantly affect or abolish the potency of our immune system to attacks of microbes. If those are the medication doses, this blue area, it's very small doses with no effect on disease and no effect on infections, of course. Now, this green area corresponds to good effect on disease without significant adverse effect on the immune system. And the red area is, of course, those are higher doses, and they are, of course, corresponding to very good response or very good effect on disease, but with significant adverse effect on the immune system. This is our playground. This green area is where we play. High enough to affect your disease in a positive way, but not so high as to abolish your immune system. For example, the dosing of the biological medicine Humira in rheumatoid arthritis. Humira is a biological medicine that is prescribed to patients with rheumatoid arthritis at a dose of one shot, one injection, which is 40 milligrams every 2 weeks. This dose is good enough to control the activity of rheumatoid arthritis without causing significant infections to the body. If you chose to consistently give it at higher doses like 160, which is 4 injections every 2 weeks instead of 40, probably you would be able to control the disease more wonderfully. But the price would be a lot of really serious infections. So we don't do that. Number three, when it comes to biological DMARDs that are more powerful, we will always prescribe only one biological medicine at a time. We don't prescribe two biological medicines together, as the inhibition of the immune system would be too much. Some new studies are investigating prescribing two agents together very cautiously, but this has not become routine practice at the moment. Number four, we instruct patients to contact their doctor at once if they get any infection so that he, she can deal with it in a timely manner and take the necessary actions of temporary withholding of any medications if needed. The next video is about medications that ease the pain in patients with autoimmune rheumatic diseases. NSAIDs, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs.